one. Welcome to Wager Talk TV, guys. I'm Kelly Stewart, joined by the man to the left of me, VR. He's got so many nicknames. Vegas runner, Gianni the Greek, right here, the man off UFC on Fox. Just got done. He's still got his makeup on from the other show. I thought he got ready just for me. Turns out not the case. All right, VR, you know I love Underdogs. So UFC has been tough for me. We've done some UFC videos before, and I'm like, VR, the reason why I can't get behind UFC is I hate laying chalk. So I look at this card, and I'm going, ooh, Holly Holmes. Look at that plus money. She took down one of the best UFC fighters of the time. She's shown a lot of promise. And I look at VR and I go, talk me out of Holly Holmes. Why? Because everybody's going to want a better against Amanda Nunes.
At that time, you're so right. That was arguably the biggest upset in UFC history when
And it was
Holly
awesome
Holmes
to be holding a Holly Holmes
knocked
ticket.
Out Ronda Rousey.
In the fashion that she did, it was so great. Now we've seen Amanda Nunes, though, just really come to her own.
And
are people wanting to bet against her?
Here's the thing. You're going to get money on Holly Holmes because of the Rousey effect. But if you, I want to steer you away from the Holly Holmes bet, and here's why. I'm not saying to go out, run, and bet Amanda Nunes, because Amanda Nunes was an underdog in six of her last seven fights, and now she's over a 3-1 favorite, around that range. So you're not getting any discount.
So maybe
discount.
A little overreaction.
Not a discount, but with Holly Holmes, this is a female fighter that has lost four of her last six bouts. That last fight she won as an underdog against Ronda Rousey, I believe, was the last time she's won as an underdog.
Right.
So I just don't see enough ways that she could... I think she'll present problems for Amanda Nunes, but I don't think she can beat her. And that's the reason I just can't get behind it. Even though the plus money looks attractive, I don't think Holly Holm has everything that it takes to beat an Amanda Nunes. There is a dog that... a plus money bet that I do like.
Okay.
It's a favorite, but by predicting the method of a victory, I think we could get plus money behind it. And the matchup is Diego Santos against Michael Chiesa. Chiesa's moved up to 175 pounds now. He's a welterweight. He's bigger. He's comfortable. And you look at Diego Santos, a couple weeks prior to this fight, he left his camp. He thought that his trainers aren't giving him enough attention. So he's like, I'm out of here. I'm going on my own. That's not a good sign.
I was
going to
say that if I had to guess, and again, I'm not a big UFC person, that's the wrong time to do it.
The worst time you could do it. Especially when you got a guy like Chiesa. When he gets on top of you, his top game's unbelievable. And I think he's going to have a lot of problems, Sanchez, holding him off. I don't see how this one lasts 15 minutes. I think Chiesa gets the submission. I think getting even money or plus 120 on that is a ton of value. Chiesa and John Jones, that's a parlay in the making. But Chiesa, inside the distance, and plus money to me is a great dog bet.
All right, guys, in the sportsbook here, cheering for soccer, but I'm walking to the window to put some plus money on Michael Chiesa, plus 120.
Indeed.
Is what you just got right before we started shooting this video. All right, guys, make sure you give the Greek Gambler, @Greek_Gambler, on Twitter, follow, and check out all of our other videos on Wager Talk TV.